Hello everyone, welcome to Insights IS. I hope you guys are doing excellent. This course is specially designed to streamline your preparation, to simplify your preparation, and to increase the hit ratio so much so that you can clear the civil services prelims exam in one go itself without waiting for the another year. With this, let's start with the first issue, that is Dhanush. Dhanush is first indigenously developed long-range artillery gun, and it is also called as Desi Bofors. And it is normal range is 36 kilometers and it is 38 kilometers with specialized ammunition. And it is 155 millimeter and 45 caliber towed artillery gun. And it is manufactured by Jabalpur based gun carriage factory, and it is located in Madhya Pradesh. Jabalpur is located in Madhya Pradesh. And this Dhanush is indigenously upgraded variant of Swadesh gun Bofors, and which was imported in during Kargil war, and it was really imported in 1980s. Transfer of technology is now happening in this case. So what are those features we'll mention? Features of Dhanush. It can be employed in all type of terrain, and it has inertial navigation system. And what is this inertial navigation system? It is a GPS aided gun recording and auto laying and encoders for positioning capability, so that it can easily identify the enemies. And it has enhanced tactical computer for board ballistic computations. It has onboard muzzle velocity recording, and it is automated gun sighting system equipped with camera as well. And it has the most upgraded variant, that is thermal imaging, so that during night time also it can work easily, because it can easily identify the infrared rays in night time. And it has laser range finder, and it has electronic upgrade aims to enhance the firing accuracies, laying speeds, and provide compatibility with Project Shakti. What is Project Shakti? Under that, Artillery Combat Command and Control System ACCS is there. There are two kinds of Project Shakti. If in prelims asked, Project Shakti is also related to women development and to increase their livelihood capabilities. And this Project Shakti is related to science and technology. There are two Project Shaktis. Guys, always remember it. Guys, remember IIT Madras developed first indigenously developed microprocessor by Rice Creek under Project Shakti, and successfully completed all trial parameters. 155 millimeter Excalibur precision guided ammunition from USA. And there is one thing, that is K9 Bajra, and it is a South Korean model, and it was assembled in India by L&T Company Limited. And another is advanced towed artillery gun, it is 80 AG. It is now is in construction, and the equipments are now designed so that after some days it will be in use as well. And another is USA M777 ULS, that is ultra light Hawaii taser. And this range is 30 kilometers, and we imported this from USA, and some nitty-gritties are there. It is now in completion process. And let's discuss about Indian ordnance factories. It is not ordnance, it is ordnance, O-R-D-N-A-N-C-E factories. So ordnance means artillery, okay? So it's an industrial setup under Department of Defense Production of the Ministry of Defense. And its headquarters is in Kolkata. And conglomerates of 41 factories are there, 9 training institutes, 3 regional marketing centers, and 4 regional controller of safety are there. Guys, in 2018 prelims, one question was asked in the prelims, that is, what is terminal high altitude area defense, that is THAAD, sometimes seen in news? The answer is C, that is an American anti-missile system. In that light, in 2013 prelims, one question was asked on INS Astradharini. I mean to say every year somehow a question on defense is they are asking, and they are going much more in details, so that you have to remember that. With this, let's move to the next topic. A1 and A2 milk. What are these A1 and A2 milk? Let's discuss in much details. So guys, remember, these milks which you are drinking every day, they are not same, because there are two types of things are there, we'll discuss. See guys, always remember, milk is a rich source of protein and calcium. In protein, there is one item that is known as casein. That is, A1 and A2 are two forms of a beta casein, which is found in protein, a subgroup of casein that is the largest protein group in milk. So actually in village areas, we found actually Desi breeds in the sense Thar Parker, Girl, Sehiwal, and Maroga. This kind of Desi breeds are found in different regions. So these Desi breeds especially are found in village areas, and which milks they produce, they are A2 rich, that is A2 beta casein rich. And in A2 beta casein, there is one amino acid known as prolein is there. And this proline is very good for our health, because this proline stops entering BCM, that is beta cosmorphin 7 opioid peptides, to enter into our body, which are toxic. And A1 protein is not that much good, because no proline amino acid is there in the A1 milk. So it is considered cause of public health issue, leading to type 1 diabetes, autism, and increased risk of heart disease and digestive issues always. Guys, for preparation purposes, we are going to Bangalore, Delhi, Chennai, Hyderabad, etc. So what happens? We are taking the milk in the morning. That always try to take the buffalo milk, because the kind of milk which is available in urban areas, they are mostly A1 rich. They are not the desi cow breed milk. So that can cause health issues in future as well. So always try to take buffalo milk or desi cow milk. See, what are the adulterant in milk? There urea, formalin, detergents, ammonium sulfate, boric acid, caustic soda, benzoic acid, salicylic acid, hydrogen peroxide, sugars, and melamine. So for preserving milk for lung purposes, they used to add these kind of things. And guys, remember, India's desi cow breeds Thar Parker, Girl, Sahiwal have a genetic makeup that yields milk high in A2. So guys, we have seen in news that some actors like Ajay Devgan and Salman Khan, they have already keeping the desi cows in their home. They have already people to take care of the cows, and they are drinking that cow milk, because for long term health purposes, it is good for us. If you become IS, immediately try to put a desi cow in your home and drink that milk, so that you can live longer. So, and all buffalo milk are rich in A2 also. And some non-dairy sources of calcium are ragi, sesam, lotus stem, drumstick, water chestnuts, etc. Guys, all kinds of millets which are available in the market, they are very good for our health. Every morning in breakfast, try to take millet. Boil it and take it. It is good for health, and it is good for brain as well. So guys, in that light, Operation Flood was taken in 1970s. It was conducted by National Dairy Development Board. Guys, in comment box, mention where is the headquarter of NDDB, that is National Dairy Development Board. So, so let's move to the next issue, that is new tree frog species found. So actually, a new species of tree frog discovered from residential area in West Bengal has been named as brown blotched Bengal tree frog, that is Polypeptides bengalensis, due to a series of 6 to 9 dark brown blotches present on its body. So very difficult to pronounce, guys. So it is a mid-sized tree frog, and it is the 26th species under the genus Polypeptides. And Polypeptides is a genus of tree frog found throughout South and Southeast Asia. Guys, you might be thinking why it is so much important, because our kind of prelims exam is like that. So in that light, a question was asked since 2016. Recently, our scientists have discovered a new and distinct species of banana plant, which attains a height of about 11 meters and has orange-colored fruit pulp. In which part of India has it been discovered? The answer was Andaman Islands. If EPSC can ask this kind of questions, they can also ask about brown blotched Bengal tree frog as well. So we have to be cautious about that. Let's move to the next issue. India, Uzbekistan. So it was in recently news, because the Defense Minister of India attended the 18th meeting of a Council of Heads of Government of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization on 2nd November 2019 in Tashkent, Uzbekistan. Guys, in comment box, mention where is the headquarter of Shanghai Cooperation Organization, because in previous lecture we have covered it in details. So the Shanghai Cooperation Organization Joint Military Exercise Center 2019, remember it. And India will host the meeting of Council of Heads of Government in 2020. So what are those highlights in from India-Uzbekistan discussions? Three Memorandum of Understanding, MOU, were signed to enhance cooperation in military medicine and military education and military training. So India affirmed its commitment to develop a state-of-the-art information technology, that is IT complex, in Armed Forces Academy of Uzbekistan for the benefit of the soldiers. So both the defense ministers presided over the inauguration of the first India-Uzbekistan joint exercise, that is Dust Lake 2019. It is important to remember it. So what are those cultural relations? Because in paper 1 also, paper 2 also, they are asking this kind of questions. That is, the cultural relations of Central Asia and India is very, very important. Please, we give due caution. So the cultural relations is, there is a close affinity between the cultures of the two countries, that is India and Uzbekistan. Indian films, actors and songs are extremely popular across Uzbekistan and also Afghanistan as well. So after the first major co-production of Alibaba or Chalis Chor, that is a movie name, in 1980, Indo-Uzbek jointly produced film Hoi Choi Unlimited, premiered in Uzbekistan on 31st March 2019. So it's an awesome movie, please watch it if you have time. The Lal Bahadur Shastri Center for Indian Culture teaches Hindi, Yoga and Kathak and holds cultural performances across Uzbekistan. In 2018, one question was asked, that is, Broad-Based Trade and Investment Agreement, that is BTIA, is sometimes seen in news in the context of negotiations held between India and which? That is, answer is option A, European Union. So because from a prelim point of view, our European countries, the all organization and Central Asia, especially the geographic locations, that is RLC, Black Sea, Uzbekistan and bordering countries, Tajikistan, Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, their bordering countries are very, very important. Please always remember it. So the next question which was asked in prelims 2019 was, recently India signed a deal known as Action Plan for Prioritization and Implementation of Cooperation Areas in the Nuclear Field. Which of the following countries? So Japan, Russia, UK, USA is there. The answer is Russia. Okay. So let's move to the next issue, that is India withdraws from RCEP. It is a hot debate and it is in news. Please watch RSTV debates with due caution and it will be very, very important, and essay can be asked on this also. So what are those reasons for withdrawal? Because see, RCEP, the background is RCEP is the part of ASEAN, and ASEAN means 10 countries are there. After adding ASEAN, means 6 countries were added to ASEAN, that is India, China, Australia, New Zealand, South Korea and Japan, and RCEP was made. So some problems India was facing in RCEP. So what are those problems? On that light, India withdraws from RCEP. So first reason is trade deficit. India has a trade deficit with at least 11 of 15 RCEP countries, and the highest is with China. It has doubled in the last 5 years from $54 billion which was in 2013 to 2014, and now it is $105 billion. It is very high trade deficit. What is trade deficit? Please mention in the comment box. Okay, so of this, China alone accounts to $53 billion. So it is so high, you know, trade deficit high mean we are importing more than export. So obviously Indian economy, if does not address this problem, will have on a crisis. So the withdrawal of India from RCEP is a good step. So signing the RCEP will widen trade deficit and will empty foreign exchange reserves of India at a faster rate. So that is the reason India withdraws from RCEP. Other reasons are the China as a headache. China is now looking for a greater access to the Indian market with a trade war with the US. A failure to find an alternative will have a cascading effect on Chinese economy, and its global ambitions, India, by not signing the RCEP deal, has refused to do to be a willing dumping ground of China's trade imperialism. So the third main reason is domestic market. Australia and New Zealand are now in search of free access to market their dairy products. Similarly, Indonesia and Vietnam are looking for places to dump their less quality rubber. India, being the largest market in the world, dumping such less expensive goods will affect domestic goods of India. Actually, India is rich in service sector, but RCEP is not agreed to take service sector. They want to trade with India and they want to export only. So India is in loss. So the withdrawal is a good step always. So next issue is ICAR report on stubble burning. Most of the cases is in Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and Haryana. New Delhi is the worst affected due to stubble burning in the three states. This year in 2019, the air quality index of Delhi is reached 99. According to World Health Organization norms, the AQI should be under 100. So Delhi is so high. So western disturbances are the main reason capable of carrying the smoke far and spread them wide when they are strong. That is, western disturbances is the keyword. Please remember it. So one question was asked in previous year prelims. That is, the term regional comprehensive economic partnership often appears in the news in the context of the affair of a group of countries known as G20, ASEAN, SEO or SARC. Already we have discussed, the answer is ASEAN. For this much is enough. Have a nice day. Bye bye.